بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تمسك بسنته بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد يا إخوان. After praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and sending the salutations upon the Messenger alayhi salatu wa salam and upon his family and his companions and upon all those who follow, upon his guidance into the establishment of the last day, to proceed, ikhwan, فَيَسِرُّ مَكْتَبَةِ الْإِمَامِ الشَّوْكَانِي رَحِمَهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى أَن تُقَدِّمَ لَكُمْ الدَّرْسَ الثَّالِثِ مِنْ الشَّرْحِ لِلْإِمَامِ الفقيه الأصولي المفسر اللغوي النحوي أبي عبد الله محمد بن صالح العثيمين على صحيح الإمام البخاري رحمهما الله تعالى رحمهما الله تعالى. So it pleases us, ya ikhwan, or it pleases the maktaba of Imam al-Shawkani to present to you the third class from the commentary of the noble Imam, the noble Shaykh of al-fiqh and of tafsir and of the Arabic language and of al-usul, Abu Abdullah Muhammad ibn Salih al-Uthaymeen, as he comments on the sahih of al-Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah ta'ala. Na'am, tafadhal.
قال ابن شهاب وأخبرني أبو سلمة بن عبد الرحمن أن جابر بن عبد الله الأنصاري قال ويحدث عن فترة الوحي فقال في حديثه بين أنا أمشي إذ سمعت صوتا من السماء فرفعت بصري فإذا الملك الذي جاءني بحراء جالس على كرسي بين السماء والأرض فرعبت منه فرجعت فقلت زملوني فأنزل الله تعالى يا أيها المدثر قم فأنذر إلى قوله والرجز فهجر فحمي الوحي وتتابع تبعه عبد الله بن يوسف وأبو صالح وتبعه هلال بن رداد عن الزهري وقال يونس ومعمر بوادر.
So now, ya ikhwan, one of the students of the Shaykh, hafidhahullah ta'ala, he begins to read the next hadith upon the Shaykh, as he says that Imam al-Bukhari, he mentions that Ibn Shihab said that Abu Salama ibn Abdul Rahman narrated to him that Jabir ibn Abdullah radiyallahu ta'ala anhu al-Ansariya radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, that he mentioned that he was narrating an fatlat al-wahi, that he was narrating with regards to the duration or the period that the revelation had begun to cease. So he mentioned in his hadith that the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam said, while I was walking, all of a sudden I heard a voice or a sound. I heard a voice call out from the heavens. So upon this I raised my vision, I raised my sight, and then I saw the angel that used to come to me when I was in the cave of Hira. And the angel, as I saw him, he was sitting upon a courtesy. He was sitting upon a chair between the heavens and between the earth. So I was extremely afraid. So I returned back, meaning to his family, and I said to them, wrap me up, wrap me up. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down the ayah that comes in Surah 2, Al-Mudathir. Ya ayyuha al-Mudathir, qum fa'andhir. O you who is wrapped up in the garments, get up and warn the people. Until Allah ta'ala revealed the ayah, wa rujza fahjur. And as for the idols, shun them and stay away from them. Then upon this he mentions, فحمي الوحي. Then the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام, he mentions that upon this the revelation began to come down to him more frequently. He says in this hadith was also followed by Abdullah ibn Yusuf and Abu Saleh, also Hilal ibn Raddad, on the authority of the great Imam al-Zuhri, also by Ma'mar رحمهم الله تعالى. تفضل.
حدثنا موسى بن إسماعيل قال حدثنا أبو عوانة قال حدثنا موسى بن أبي عائشة قال حدثنا
الله من يشير إلى نعم هو دور
قال حدثنا سعيد بن جبير عن ابن عباس في قوله تعالى لا تحرك به لسانك لتعجل به قال كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يعالج من التنزيل شدة وكان مما يحرك شفتيه فقال ابن عباس فأنا أحركهما لكم كما كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يحركهما وقال سعيد أنا أحركهما كما رأيت ابن عباس يحركهما فحرك شفتيه فأنزل الله تعالى لا تحرك به لسانك لتعجل به إن علينا جمعه وقرآنه.
So now the student, as for this hadith that we just mentioned, the Shaykh told the brother to proceed to the next hadith. He didn't comment on that previous hadith as it was similar to the hadith that he already commented on. So the brother continues. He says, then Imam al-Bukhari mentions that Musa ibn Ismail narrated to them, that Abu Awana narrated to them, who said that Musa ibn Abi Aisha narrated to them, who said that Sa'id ibn Jubayr narrated to them on the authority of Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, that he commented on the verse that Allah Ta'ala revealed in Surah Al-Qiyamah, where Allah Ta'ala says, لا تحرك به لسانك لتعجل به. Allah Ta'ala says, and do not move your tongue therein, O Muhammad, seeking to cause haste, or seeking haste. In Surah Al-Qiyamah, he goes on to mention that Imam al-Bukhari says, and then the Messenger alayhi salatu salam, he used to, when the revelation came upon him, he used to endure with difficulty, extreme difficulty. He said, so upon this the Prophet alayhi salam used to move his move his lips. So Ibn Abbas, while narrating this hadith, he said, and I am moving my lips to you just as the Messenger of Allah, I saw him move his lips. Sa'id ibn Tayyib. Then he goes on to mention that Sa'id, the sub-narrator, he says, and I am moving my lips to you just as I saw Ibn Abbas move his lips to us. So he moved his lips, and then Allah Ta'ala revealed the ayah, do not تُحَرِّكْ بِهِ لِسَانَكَ, do not move your lips, O Muhammad, seeking haste therein, إِنَّ عَلَيْنَا جَمَعَهُ الْقُرْآنَ. And then he recited the following verse, for indeed it's upon us, meaning Allah, to bring it together and to recite it to you, to give it to you.
قَالَ جَمَّعُوا لَكَ فِي صَدْرِكْ وَتَقْرَأْ فَإِذَا قَرَأْنَاهُ فَاتَّبِعْ قُرْآنَ قَالَ فَاسْتَمِعْ لَهُ وَأَنصِتْ ثم إن علينا بيانه ثم إن علينا أن تقرأه فكان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بعد ذلك إذا أتاه جبريل استمع فإذا انطلق جبريل قرأه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كما قرأ.
So the student, he goes on to continue the hadith upon the Shaykh Al-Uthaymeen rahimahullah. He says, so then Imam Al-Bukhari, he mentions that he says جَمَعُهُ لَكَ فِي صَدْرِكَ. He said that he gathered it together for you, O Muhammad, in your chest, in your heart, by memory. وَتَقْرَأَهُ. And then you recite it. He says, as for the next verse, فَإِذَا قَرَأْنَهُ فَاتَّبِعْ قُرْآنَ. And then when we, meaning Allah, and the messenger, by way of the messenger Jibreel, or the angel Jibreel, to the messenger, when we have recited it, given it to you, O Muhammad, قُرْآنَ. As the rest, then follow, فَاتَّبِعْ قُرْآنَ, then follow its recitation, its recitation. Imam al-Bukhari, he mentions, he says, فَاسْتَمِعْ لَهُ وَأَنصِتْ. He says, meaning, then listen to it, O Muhammad, and pay close attention. As Allah Ta'ala says, and then it's upon us, meaning Allah, بَيَانَ, to clarify it, and to make it clear for you, or make it clear. Then he goes on to mention the next, the statement of Bukhari, as he explains that ayah, then it's upon us to recite it upon you. So the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, after that, whenever the angel Jibril would come to him, he would listen to him. And then when Jibril would depart, the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, would recite that which Jibril recited upon him, just as it was recited to him. No.
تكفل الله عز وجل بجمع القرآن
So the Imam Al Uthaymeen, he begins his commentary. Rahimahullah. He says, as for these ayat, ya ikhwan, they contain therein benefit. They contain therein benefit. As for the statement of Allah Ta'ala, verily it's upon us, meaning Allah, jama'ahu, to collect it and gather it together, wa Qur'ana, and its recital, or its recitation. He says, in this ayah, we see that Allah Ta'ala takaffala, that Allah guaranteed, and He took the responsibility of gathering the Qur'an and reciting the Qur'an upon the Messenger, Muhammad, alayhi salatu wa salam. عليه الصلاة والسلام.
فإذا قرأناه والقارئ جبريل، لكنه لما كان رسولا لله عز وجل صارت قراءته كقراءة الله، فقول جبريل من قول الله ولم يأتي إلا بما قال الله عز وجل.
The Sheikh says another benefit, as Allah Ta'ala He says, فإذا قرأناه فاتبع قرآنا. He says, so when we recite it, O Muhammad, then follow what has been recited, or follow its recital. The Imam Al-Uthaymeen, he mentions the reciter here, the one reciting here the actual words, he is Jibril, alayhi salam. He says, however, the fact that he is the Messenger, alayhi salatu salam, and he is reciting what Allah Ta'ala has commanded him to recite to Muhammad, he said, then his recital becomes like the recital of Allah. So Jibril is saying that which is the speech of Allah, and he does not say except that which Allah Ta'ala has said. So the Imam, he continues. He says, as for the ayah, as Allah Ta'ala says, then it's upon us, meaning Allah, bayana, to clarify it for you. The Imam Al-Uthaymeen, he mentions, so here Allah Ta'ala requires, he requires upon himself that he is the one that gathered the Quran, and that he shall recite it upon the Messenger, alayhi salatu salam, by way of a mediator. And this mediator is Jibril, alayhi salatu wassalam. He says, and then after that, Allah Ta'ala requires upon himself also that he is going to clarify it, so nothing remains from it hidden. So there's nothing hidden from the Quran. And he says, and this is from the completion of the great concern of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with regards to his speech, meaning the Quran. And that Allah Ta'ala preserved this Quran originally. And Allah Ta'ala requires upon himself that he's going to gather it. He says, so for this is an obligation upon us to realize and to understand, and to understand that there's nothing therein that someone does not know. That someone does not know. Because that is never like this. He says, however, he says, so it's, from the Quran, it's a must to understand that there's some people, there's always going to remain some people that have knowledge of his meanings. He said, yet, it may be hidden and unknown to others from his creation. He says, however, it's impossible for the meanings of the Quran to be hidden from all of the people. It's impossible. Some of the people are going to know and have knowledge of the meanings of the Quran. So there's not going to be any single word, absolutely, one word, that is the meaning of this word is hidden from all of the people. This is impossible.
عندنا قال ثم إن علينا بيان وقال ونزلنا عليك الكتاب تبيان لكل شيء.
As Allah Ta'ala, He mentions, the Shaykh reiterated the ayah, for indeed it's upon us to clarify for you, Surah Al-Qiyamah. And Allah Ta'ala also mentions in Surah Al-Nahl, وَنَزَّلْنَا عَلَيْكَ الْكِتَابَ تِبْيَانًا لِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ. Allah Ta'ala, He says, as the Imam Al-Uthaymeen mentions, and indeed we, meaning Allah, have sent down upon you, O Muhammad, the book, تِبْيَانًا, clarifying, and explaining لكل شيء, everything.
وقال لتبين الناس ما نزل عليك ولعلهم يتقون.
He says, also Allah Ta'ala, He says, in another ayah in the same surah, Surah An-Nahl, لتبين للناس, meaning for you, O Muhammad, to make it clear to the people, ما نزل إليهم, that which has been sent upon them, وَلَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ, so that perhaps they will comprehend, so that perhaps they will understand. Surah An-Nahl, Surah An-Nahl.
وبهذا نعرف بطلان مذهب أهل التفويض الذين يقولون في آيات الصفات الله أعلم ما ندري ما أراد الله.
He says, and for this we see, Ikhwan, the falsehood of the madhab of the people of Tafwid, those who they say with regards to the ayats of Allah that contain therein His descriptions and His qualities and attributes, they say Allah knows the meanings only. As for us, we do not know what Allah truly intends. The Shaykh says, as for this statement here, this statement is a statement of falsehood. He says, and this is how the falasifa wal malahida, the people of philosophy and the likes, when they came about and they used to say in their statement, in their foolish statement, their incorrect, corrupt, false statement, they would say, so even if you don't know the meanings or of the ayah, then you're still considered to be from the people who understand the meaning. So the Sheikh says, in reality, you are juhalun mutawarri'un, that these people, they are foolish and they are ignorant. No. He says, and they also used to say, these individuals of philosophy, and they would say, and we, us, themselves, we are the true scholars, and you are the ignorant ones. He says, so now one of the students, Ikhwan, and once again, the questions of the students are not as loud as you can hear. So we can't really hear the actual questions originally. But he was speaking about the Torah and the Injil. He mentions that the Injil is a mutammima, is a completion of the Torah.
والحمد لله ما دام الأذان فرض كفاية والبلد فيها مؤذنون يسمع أذانه بكل مكان يكفي. لكن المشكلة إذا قالها في الصلاة هذه المشكلة. بعض الأئمة إذا سجد يقول الله أكبر، لم يأتي الواجب. الحل أنه ينبه، قال هذا ما يجوز. نعم قد يقال ان هذا الجاهل ما يدري يرفع عنه، لا سيما على القول بان التكبيرات سوى الاسود والاحرام سنه.
خلص
بن داود. ها خلص. نعم.
حدثنا عبدان قال اخبرنا عبد الله قال اخبرنا يونس عن الزهري حاء، وحدثنا بشر بن محمد قال اخبرنا عبد الله قال اخبرنا يونس ومعمر عن الزهري نحوه، قال أخبرني عبيد الله بن عبد الله عن ابن عباس قال كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أجود الناس، وكان أجود ما يكون في رمضان حين يلقاه جبريل، وكان يلقاه في كل ليلة من رمضان فيدارسه القرآن، فلرسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أجود بالخير من الريح المرسلة.
So now the student, he goes on to read the next hadith upon the Shaykh. As he said, then Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentions that his Shaykh Abadanu narrated to them, that his Shaykh Abdullah narrated to them, that his Shaykh Yunus narrated to them on the authority of al-Imam al-Zuhri. Then Imam al-Bukhari, he mentions ha. Translators note, this ha means tahwil al-sanad. It means Bukhari heard this narration from another way also. So he mentions both ways that he actually heard this narration. So he says ha. Now he's going to the next narration, meaning the next way that he heard this hadith that we're going to present. He says, rahimahullah, that his Shaykh Bishr ibn Muhammad narrated to them, who said that Abdullah narrated to them, who said that Yunus and Ma'mar both narrated to them on the authority of the great Imam Az-Zuhri. Similarly, he goes on to say that Abdullah ibn Ubaydullah ibn Abdullah informed him on the authority of Abdullah ibn Abbas. So this hadith is narrated by Ibn Abbas, but it came to Bukhari from two ways. That the Messenger alayhi salatu salam, that he was the most generous of the people, and he was the most generous in the month of Ramadan, when Jibril alayhi salatu salam used to come to him. And he used to come to him alayhi salatu salam every night from the nights of the month of Ramadan, and he would review and go over and teach him the Quran. And the Messenger alayhi salatu salam was more generous from carrying out good, more so than the winds that have been sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now.
Allahumma salli ala wa sallam. والحكمة في كونه يدرس في رمضان أنه الشهر الذي نزل فيه القرآن.
So the Imam al-Uthaymeen rahimahullah, he says, as for the wisdom of him teaching him and reviewing with him and reading and rehearsing with the Messenger of Allah the Quran, meaning Jibril, he says, this is because in the month of Ramadan, this is the month that the Quran was sent down upon him, alayhi salam. So this is the wisdom of him doing this with Jibril rehearsing and teaching him and reviewing with him the Quran in Ramadan, because this was the month that the Quran was revealed. He says, and once again, the wisdom of him, alayhi salatu salam, reviewing the Quran with Jibril, or rather, Jibril rehearsing and reviewing the Quran with him, meaning the Messenger of Allah, he said, every year, this was in order to make it dhabt, to make it precise and more accurate. That was the Messenger of Allah, what has been revealed upon him, so it could be more accurate to him when he recited it. And to remember the revelation as Jibril will descend with it upon him, alayhi salatu wassalam. Alayhi salatu wassalam. Now. Tafadhal.